Did you ever wonder if there is a command that combines two or more tables based on a related column between them? This is John from Java Code Geeks, and today I'm going to show you how to write clean and efficient code in SQL by using joins. A join clause corresponding to a join operation in algebra combines columns from one or two tables into a new table to be able to use this information from two tables as one. Now, complementary to this video tutorial, you can find the related articles and resources in the description below. Of course, you can visit Java Code Geeks to stay up to date with everything Java related. Just before we continue, if you guys like these guides and videos, take a minute to subscribe, like, and hit that notification bell just so you know when the next video is up. So with no further ado, let's get started! Join is a widely used clause in SQL Server essentially to combine and retrieve data from two or more tables. In a real-world relational database, data is structured in a large number of tables, which is why there is a constant need to join these multiple tables based on a logical relationship between them. The types of joins in SQL Server are the inner join, the left join, the right join, the full join, the cross join, and the self join. The most used types of SQL joins are, at first is the inner join which returns all the records which have matching values in both tables. Secondly is the left outer join which returns all the records from the left table and all the matching records from the right table. Thirdly is the right outer join which returns all the records from the right table and all the matching records from the left table. Furthermore, there is the full outer join which returns all the records where there is a match from either left or right table, and last but not least is the self join, which is a regular join but the table is joined with itself. As we said before, the reasons that we use joins is to be able to unify, select and use the information from two or multiple tables which have the same characteristics. But how you can select the columns from the final table that you want to display? Filtering is a useful way to see the data or the information that you want to display. You can use filters to display specific records from a dataset, form, report or query, or to be able to print only certain records from a table, query or report. By applying a filter, you'll be able to limit the data in a view without altering the design of the underlying object. You can select a filter from a several ready-to-use filters for any data type. The filters types are, at first is the common filters, filter by selection, filter by form, and last but not least, the advanced filters. For SQL databases and internal data types, the filter is the SQL where clause that provides comparisons that must be true to be able to return the data. The comparisons are between the field names and their values. The syntax of the filter, SQL filter, is provided by the underlying data source. The SQL filter is the content of the SQL where clause with format provided by the underlying database. When the data is retrieved by the underlying data source, it passed directly to the underlying database for processing. For internal data types, the syntax is that where the field is the name of the data type field, the operator is a comparative operator, and last but not least, the value is the field value. The first thing that we need to do in this example is to create two tables to be able to join them. The first table has the name class, which contains the information of every student of this class. This table has five column parameters: the number, the name, the address, the father, and the age of every student, with the first and the last being integer and the rest of them will be varchars. The primary key of this table is number. The second table is the courses, which contains two column parameters: the course ID, which has every course which every student must follow, and the number of every student. The primary key of this table is number. The next step is to insert some information about the students inside the two tables. In the courses tables, we want to insert different values in the column number because we need to notice the differences between the joins commands later. The first join command that we need to use is the inner join. So we select to see the name, the courses ID, and the age of every student from the two tables, where the number of the two tables are the same, so we execute the program. As we can see, this keyword will create the result set by combining all the rows from both tables when the condition is true. As now for the left, right and full outer join, we can select to display the same characteristics and the same condition and we execute the program. If we execute the program, we will see that the table that uses the left join, the rows for which there is no matching, the result set contains null. And for the table that uses the right join, the rows for which there is no matching at the left side, the result set contains null. As now for the full outer join, the table creates a result set by combining results of left and right join. The result set contains all the rows from a left and a right join. So we can see that the rows for which there is no matching at the full outer join, the result set will contain null values. The main advantage of using joins is that it executes faster. The increase of the performance may not be noticeable by the end user. However, because of the columns are specifically named, indexed, and optimized by the database engine, the retrieval time most of the times are faster than the subqueries. Also, there are many types of joins that we can use. One of the disadvantages of using joins is that not as easy to read as the subqueries. Last but not least, it is confusing to choose the appropriate type for a specific correct result. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to smash the like button and subscribe to our channel. We have some really cool stuff coming up. Bye!